So we have seen till now individual behavior of three resistance offering elements, resistor, inductor and capacitor, while they are connected with AC source. Now what happened when we join all these three components in series? That turns out to be LCR series circuit. Where inductor, capacitor and resistance, all three are connected in series. So we consider inductor of inductance L, capacitor of capacitance C and resistor of resistance R are connected in series. So E is equal to E naught sin omega t is applied potential difference. If I say that VL is potential difference across inductor, VC is potential difference across capacitor, VR is potential difference across resistor. Fine. So this you have to do on the basis of phasor diagram. So let's see the phasor diagram for EMF. Phasor diagram for EMF with respect to the current, that is, if I take current is flowing in the circuit while only resistor is there along x-axis, then VR will be along this, V will be at 90 degrees this side and VC will be somewhere here down. So along with the phasor angle or phase angle, this EMF has become vector quantity. So you can produce an equivalent diagram assuming if we say VL is greater than VC, then these are two vectors which are acting in opposite direction. So resultant will be up. That is VL minus VC, VR is here, so resultant you can find by this formula, net voltage V angle phi, right? So V is equal to VR whole square, VL minus VC whole square. This will be the result you will find by using Pythagoras theorem. But if I say VR, I can write it as I into R, VL I can write into XL, XL is the resistance offered by an inductor, and VC I can write it as I into XC. So when we substitute this here and V, I can put it equal to I into Z. So let's put up these values in equation number 1. You will have I square Z square, I square R square plus I square, you can take out common, XL minus XC whole square, I square cancels. So Z is equal to R square XL minus XC whole square, square root of this, right? Where Z is termed as impedance. What does Z is known as? Where Z is called impedance. What do I mean with impedance? Like R is a resistance offered by the resistor, XL is a resistance offered by an inductor, XC is a resistance offered by the capacitor. When all these three components are placed in series across an alternating EMF source, Z is net EMF produced. Z is net resistance offered by all three components together to the AC source. Similarly, V is the net voltage which will appear. Now, this you can also make and represent in terms of a triangle. This is basically your Pythagoras theorem. So you can say R is here, XL minus XC is here. You can draw an equivalent length line segment, join this. This is Z. This is phase angle between current and EMF. This is XL minus XC. So this is termed as impedance triangle. See now. This is termed as impedance triangle. What is the phase angle between applied EMF and current in LCR circuit? You can say tan phi is equal to XL minus XC over R. This is the phase angle. Now, XL and XC both are varying according to the frequency. If somebody asks you to plot variation of impedance with respect to the frequency of AC source, this was also a question in the CBSE. Right. So that I will let you know how can you plot because you have to learn one thing more in that is termed as resonance circuit. So when we go to LCR series resonance circuit, then we will show you the graph, or we can put it in conceptual question, you can see later. Now, this is all about the impedance of LCR series circuit. Now, one thing comes in the mind, why we are studying? Do I need to apply all these concepts somewhere? Answer is yes. We physicists not do anything without usage of it. Have you seen ever a transmission line which is carrying a high voltage power and supplying to the cities? You might have seen high transmission lines even in your area. If you go down to this wire and watch it closely, you will find this wire is made up of large number of thin aluminium wires, and these large number of thin aluminium wires are coiled up together. That gives a thickness to the wire, like this. And like this, another wire is also there. Right? Now, every practical conductor, once it is coiled, it possesses resistance, and if it is given shape of a coil, then it starts behaving as an inductor also. So a practical inductor coil also carries resistance, because after all it is made up of some conductor. Now, There are always two ways to carry, one for positive and another for negative or returning back. In between these two wires there is a gap. This is one conductor, this is another conductor, so this gives a capacitor. Right. So before transmitting power from generating station, power generating station to any city, you must count the impedance of the line. If you don't know the impedance of line, then probably you will be totally failure to meet the conditions and requirement of the supply in the city. Because you don't know the impedance of this line, it means you don't know that how much power is going to waste on the way. Suppose you supply a demand of the town is say 4000 watt. You thought that the town needs this much voltage, so you have given input of 4000 watt. As a result of impedance of this line, say 3000 watt is consumed or lost in form of heat or something else. Now you can imagine, how can you meet with the condition of the town or requirement of the town? Probably the town will remain in dark. So obviously, since you are learning with electricity, so all these concepts are supposed to be used in electricity. You cannot imagine that you are going to use it while you are going to buy vegetables. Sabji kharidne mein zarurat nahi hai. So we have learned individual behavior of resistor, capacitor, inductor, and when all three are combined in series. So in LCR series circuit, you can further classify it into three types, interestingly. Impedance of this is R square XL minus XC whole square. Square root of this. Right? Now what I am doing, making combination. Out of these three elements, we will combine two together. So first is LR circuit. Second, you can say RC circuit. Third, you can say LC circuit. Now, these combination of individual element also has their individual significance in electricity. LR circuit is basically a choke coil. And choke coil you must have seen in your old tube lights, I mean to say not LED tube lights, they used to carry on the your board a small box kind of thing. That was choke coil. Choke coil is made up of LR circuit. What it does, it basically controls AC current. What it does? It controls AC current. Now, how do I find impedance of this LR circuit? So, what is missing? C. So, put XC is equal to 0. You will get Z is equal to R square plus XL square square root. And phase angle between applied EMF and current is XL over R. RC circuit is basically a filter circuit. What kind of filter is this? It is not to filtrate your tea leaves from the tea and keep tea in the cup. Filter circuit eliminates AC and DC component if they are mixed up somehow. This you will also learn in a coming time. So what is, I repeat, filter circuit does what? It eliminates AC components and DC component if you are getting any output in which AC and DC components are mixed up. What is missing? XL. So put XL is equal to 0. Then Z is equal to R square, XC square, square root of this. And phase angle tan phi is equal to minus XC over R. LC circuit is basically an oscillator. Electrical oscillator. So what is not there? R is equal to 0. It means XL minus XC is equal to Z. And tan phi, you can get what? XL minus XC over R, that is 0. So tan phi is equal to infinite, then phase angle is 90 degree. Right, in case of the oscillators. So these are three important applications that are the sub parts of LCR series circuit also. You can have numerical problem or any formula which you have studied so far.